I'm Ryan. 143rd day of running. I did the 5K today on the mill. The eyes are just, they're not working with me outside. So hopefully I'll get over this hump soon and be able to enjoy some outside runs. But I just want to itch them, take out the eyeballs and roll them in sand. And it sounds disgusting, but that would feel so good to itch my eyes. I'm not. 143rd day of the year also means 143rd morning babble. But today is officially, at least in PA, happy 143 day. This is in honor of the late Fred Rogers, and he would do on his show, I love, four letters, you, three. And don't have to go around telling people that you love them today. I mean, if you do, knock yourself out. Go for it. But it's encouraging everyone to do something kind to someone else today. So whether you hold a door, get someone a cup of coffee, give somebody a call and say, hey, I'm thinking about you. Do that today on 143 day. Typically I talk about books on a Sunday, and Fred Rogers' book is Good Neighbor, The Life and Work of Fred Rogers, and that came out a couple years ago. Maxwell King wrote that. I don't have it, it's on one of my wish lists. I've heard tremendous things about it. Would love to dive into it, especially when you have a day like today and you see all these articles on Mr. Rogers, and you're like, oh, that's another guy I should learn and know more about and be more like. All this stuff I'll put at brentevans.net. Book-wise for me, I mean, still just same books, digging deeper. Hoping next weekend, Memorial Day weekend, I'll be able to figure out like just a couple hours of time and I'll just knock this one out. I haven't started it, I'm just carrying it around, and when I know I can sit still for a couple hours, bam! Gonna knock that one out. This book, last night, Leadership, Doris Kearns Goodwin. I'm over 100 pages in, talking about Lincoln. And Lincoln was nutty. I didn't realize. Here's a line. The doctors in Springfield believed that Lincoln was within an inch of being a perfect lunatic for life. His friends were saying he's roaming around the woods with a gun, not doing well. He obviously turned it around. I'm now getting into some of the unbelievable focus that he had and how he learned himself on so many different things, and just his driven ability to get to that next step. So fascinating book, this one. What else I want to... David Goggins. I have been listening to... This is the one audiobook I'm listening to. I only listen to one audiobook at a time. But it's taken me forever. This is the book, Can't Hurt Me. But the problem is, and it's a good problem, but if I listen to it while running on the mill or outside or just walking around the house, I find myself having to stop so much to write down good things. I mean, if it was a book, it'd probably be marked up like that. All those pages I got marked for this book. And I think the David Goggins book would be the same way. So, just keep stopping it. And, one of the things he was talking about, the accountability mirror. And this is when you look in the mirror and you're just raw and cold and kind of mean to yourself, just telling yourself, look at you, you're a mess, just pushing you to get to that next level. He stresses to pick the people around you that are going to hold you to that higher standard, not a lower standard. And states that most people are afraid to hear what they just don't want to hear. I'm enjoying it. David Goggins, Can't Hurt Me. I should be wrapping that one up soon. I already have my next audiobook that I'm looking forward to. I'll talk about that maybe next weekend, but it's amazing. I'll keep stopping my stop buttons on my up here, so that's why. Oh, well. I keep stopping it because it's good stuff and I gotta scribble it down. All right. Quote of the day. There are three ways to ultimate success. The first way is to be kind. The second way is to be kind. The third way is to be kind. Yeah, Fred, Mr. Rogers. Put that one close. So, enjoy 1-4-3 day. Make it a good one. Ooh, tomorrow's Monday. Just enjoy today. Just enjoy it. Make it a good one.